It's Madden NFL 23, and we've got some history in this battle of AFL alumni. It's the Buffalo Bills and the New England Patriots, and it's all up next on EA Sports.
It is a chilly night here in the northeastern U.S., but we've got some football to keep us warm at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. Tonight, we've got a good AFC matchup on tap between the Buffalo Bills and the New England Patriots. And hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking, tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
Tyler Bass about ready to get us going. And we are underway in Foxborough. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. A time for Mac Jones and his Patriot offense to take the field. Jones now in his second season since being selected 15th overall in 2021.
Mac Jones absolutely believed in himself coming out of high school. Went to Alabama despite the fact there were many high-profile quarterbacks already on the roster and blossomed into a Heisman Trophy candidate in his final season with 41 touchdowns and only 4 interceptions. Steady, consistent as a passer, doesn't have the biggest cannon for an arm, but can stretch the field and lay those passes in on the deep ball.
Jones wants to throw to start things out here. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. These two AFC East rivals, Buffalo and New England, and the Bills, they've kind of flipped the script the last few years in this series. The Patriots own the division for so long, won 16 times in 17 years. But it's the Bills who have captured the title the last 2 years, and they crushed the Pats in the wild card round last year, you might remember, in Buffalo, 47-17. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. Well, first drive here and the first time that we've called a big tight end's name, but I can assure you this, Charles, it won't be the last.
No, it won't, because when he gets going, now it opens up opportunities on the perimeter because that'll draw the defense towards him in the middle of the field. Now your wide receivers will get involved as this game goes on.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. A bit of a jump there, CD. He breaks the line and that'll be 5 yards.
And you've got to stay more disciplined than that, Brandon. That's just a free gift to the offense.
So a first and 5 now after the 5-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction. Out of the gun, they give it to Stevenson. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Now Jones. He's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there. That brings up fourth.
And third down is a key down in any game you play, and third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi.
Back deep, Nyheim Hines.
42 yards on the punt, just two on the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10.
Now here come the Bills, and you don't have to look hard to find their fifth-year star QB, taken seventh overall back in 2018, Josh Allen.
I remember when he came out of Wyoming, the big question mark, could he be accurate enough to be a star in the NFL? I think it's safe to say he's put all of us in our place and put those doubts to rest. He can roll out and run it. He can bomb it over your heads. Everything in between. He is an absolute nightmare for defenses to try and prepare for. And when he's on, he's an MVP caliber player each and every time he takes the field.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 18. Throwing to start the drive. Allen. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down.
Devon Godshaw getting in there and dropping it.
They had the greatest field position to start, didn't they? And now after this sack, it's way, way worse.
And right off the bat, first play of the game. Hey, that's what we got. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. And not much there at all, as he'll get this only up to about the 11. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And maybe they were coming with a blitz that time and it caused a jump.
I think if we saw it, you know that they saw it. Might have been a little discussion down there. Bad guys coming. Pick them up. Pick them up. And someone jumped.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. This to Hines on the drop-off. 17 yards on the pickup. And that'll bring up fourth down.
I don't know how many times, not just in my playing career, but you and I working together, have we ever heard a coach say, you know, I just don't have that play on my call sheet. And that's really what we had here. That was a big hole they were trying to get out of.
Yeah, big gain, still a ways to go, though.
So now on fourth down, Sam Martin on to punt for Buffalo. And deep to return it is Marcus Jones.
Fielded at the 33. They'll call this a 41-yard punt, 7 on the return. And the Patriots take over.
So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive. A last series form, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10.
Very good starting position for the Patriot offense as they come up first and 10 at the 40.
They run with a fourth year man. This is Damian Harris to the 43, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Throwing, Jones. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Harris running straight ahead. Oh, look at the juke. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Someone's looking fresh, and this O-line is definitely licking their chops. Everyone likes to run block. If you're an offensive lineman, nice early burst, nice gain, too.
Eight yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Off play action. Jones. Open receiver here. Complete. It's Parker. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Second and short. That's a rundown. So it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
Five yards from the end zone, first and goal. On the give, this is Harris. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. It'll be a pickup of 4, and it brings up second and goal.
As long as you've been the air attack, that's gotten them down here, but now is where you start to lean on that running game. That's a good pickup there on first and goal.
Second and goal from the 1. They'll try and run with Harris. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They'll try to run with Harris. And he keeps fighting his way into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Damian Harris taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Patriots put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up, never even got to it.
Nick Folk for the point after. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it was Damian Harris who finished things off with a touchdown run. Now set to boot it after his guys put 6 on the board. Fields it right around the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
So here come the Bills out for their second drive.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
It'll go as a gain of four, and it's second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position.
Throw it across his body and it's intercepted. And the Patriots are going to take possession of the football.
Partner, I think this one went awry very simply because he overestimated his arm strength and his ability to fit it anywhere he wants to. A lot of quarterbacks do that and often pay the price.
New England's offense set to go. They'll have good field position here following the interception and a chance to build on their lead as they start with a first and 10. Now a first down carry for Harris. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Ed Oliver through the line and hitting him for the loss.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter from Foxborough. It's the homestanding Patriots with the football as they've got it second down and 12. Back to throw. Jones. And right side hitter's got it. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
An extra defensive back here for the Bills on third down. Operating from the gun, Jones. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
So on fourth down, Jones jogs off, and on comes a longtime vet, Nick Folk, for the Pats field goal try. Folk's kick is good,
and that will extend their lead even further.
So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
After the made field goal, back out is Nick Folk to kick this one off.
Taking it about the one. And he returns this to the 22. Back now on offense, the Buffalo Bills.
Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ballgame as they come up first and 10.
Come on, baby. trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. They'll come up now on second and a yard. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. It's a pickup of 17 on that one, and a Bills first down.
I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme. When you have a blocker on a defender, and then the running back can read it, find the proper hole, and just go, it's sometimes a thing of beauty.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On play action, Allen. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Allen off the play fake. And Diggs has it. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 22 yards there, a first down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 as they're down to the 29-yard line. Allen going to throw. Another target for Stephon Diggs, and he brings it in. Touchdown, Bills! Stephon Diggs, 29 yards. And the Bills are back within a score. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. So that drive spanned 5 plays. And it's finished off by the touchdown by Stephon Diggs.
What's the deal, y'all?
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. New England trying to get to place on offense.
And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
They go play action here on first down. And his throw here is incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet.
Second and 10 now from the 27. They hand this off to Harris. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
New England on third down, just one for three thus far. This is going to be third and 13. He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? Guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field. Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route, well run, and the football, right on the money.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Looking to throw. Jones got his man complete over the middle. That's Henry. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved. Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe trying to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
Jones looking to throw on second down. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game planned for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Allen's throw going to be caught by Davis. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. A give up the middle to Singletary. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down. From the gun, it's Allen. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
Good clean play. No flags coming out of the pocket of the officials. Turns into an incompletion, and that should get them off the field with a three and out.
On fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. And here's a fair catch taken at about the 24-yard line. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. The Pats at the line, ready to go.
As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls at work. Now, they've got to build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover the play did on the last one.
Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Back to throw, Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down.
And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. Back to throw again. Open man is Jacoby Myers. He's got it. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And throw right side complete to Parker.
And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Myers. Touchdown, Patriots! Jacoby Myers, an 18-yard touchdown grab.
And the Patriots will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
Partner, to me, that touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that group seeing the future. What I mean by that is they had a plan. Let's find a way to score right here before the half, and that'll give us momentum going into the second half, give us that cushion that we're looking for. They got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
Fulk connects on the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards.
And it was all capped off by Jacoby Myers on the touchdown reception.
Now set to boot it after his guys put 6 on the board.
From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Bills' offense now for one final time in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. Now Allen. And complete right side to Cook. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Throwing again on second down. Allen setting up the screen for Cook. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. So we've reached halftime here at Gillette Stadium with the Patriots on top. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for the Bills. And they didn't get a whole lot accomplished through the air in those first 2 quarters of play. They'll need to up their game if they want to rally all the way back. Meanwhile, for the Patriots, they were even better throwing the football. Lots of open receivers to choose from, and you can bet that'll continue to be a focus in the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Bills trail here, but they will get the football first as we are back underway on EA Sports. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. The Bills offense set to take over to begin quarter number 3. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter 3.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down. Those are the type of runs that we did not see from him in the first half, but a good start to the third quarter.
And I know what everyone's thinking that's watching this. They did a great job adjusting at the half. Oftentimes, you don't make adjustments. You just dial into your game plan a little bit better, and maybe they're starting to make some headway.
On first down, Allen. There's Stephon Diggs for the catch on the slant. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
A couple of first downs right in succession, and this is an offense that could really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
So into Pats territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. Singletary, they'll go up the middle. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Right back to Singletary on second down. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. 47 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. To throw, it's Allen. Finding Knox there, complete. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
From the 28, it's second and 5. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. Got his man complete over the middle. That's McKenzie. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
From the red zone now. Allen on the slant. He's got Davis. And the Bills are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll run with Cook. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. James Cook, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bills have got it back to within a score.
A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Oh, the return is Jones from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
So here are the Patriots now. They get ready for their first possession of half number two.
And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
Now Jones. And he fires one that's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick.
Well, NFL quarterbacks have learned the hard way. You're not going to get rich throwing against this guy. He's definitely too good. And this is now his second interception of the ball game. And if I'm running the offense, I've got to tell my guys, you've got to go work on the other corner.
The Bills ready to take over. And down by a field goal, they'll take over with excellent field position following the interception. So after the INT, it's Allen. And Cook has it, left side. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid gain.
From the 17, Allen, it's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And the Bills are going to be set up with a first and goal here as the tackle made at the 9.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Allen. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Two of their three red zone trips so far they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Now Allen again. And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Gabriel Davis, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Bills have scored again in this third quarter, this time to move out in front.
Oh, such great concentration there, going right up against the side of the end zone, but able to get the feet in bounds.
There are so many things that go into that catch, and you just mentioned the concentration, being able to catch the football, get your feet down in bounds, hang on to it all the way through the process of the catch. That was a phenomenal play.
Here's Bass now for the extra point. It's up and good to make it 21-17. So that drive, 4 plays. And it ends with a touchdown pass to Gabriel Davis. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Fields it right around the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. New England's offense set to go. This offense returning out there, and really, you remember the last drive, Charles, it was over before it even began. They threw the interception on the very first play.
And what that means is for all these guys, it's been a while since they've been out there going full speed, so they've got to get everyone back out there, run a couple of your go-to plays, make sure you get your offense oiled up a little bit. They've got to be able to start fast, but they've got to be efficient as well.
Especially the quarterback.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's got a man complete. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Throwing Jones.
Setting up a screen for Stevenson.
And down right around the 32-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Coming up on a 2nd and 6.
They run with Harris. And only able to get 2 here. Stopped at the 30. Now they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half. And that's sort of continuing here in the 3rd quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse. And I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
In need of a conversion on 3rd down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Operating from the gun. Jones. And that will be incomplete. Well, the other day they told us when we've got 3rd and 5 or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity missed there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had. Thought they could exploit them. Unable to do so on that play.
Folks, kick is good,
and that'll bring him back within a point.
So the 3 points there, and CD, that helps him inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
After the main field goal, back out is Nick Folk to kick this one off.
McKenzie now from his end zone.
And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here.
And as the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again. But we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
Yeah, we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the 3rd quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. From the 22, Allen. A good decision in the end to pull it and run. Gets him 9 yards and a first.
getting cold in here, partner, because it looks like he's trying to ice this one away. Yeah, I know, bad dad joke, but what the heck, right? Scrambling for that first after the D blanketed his receivers, that's a backbreaker for the defense. They finish this drive off with six, and this one could be over.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. So the shotgun snap to Allen. Over the middle, complete. It's McKenzie. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
To throw again on second down. Allen. Left side caught by Diggs. And they're going to get this up to midfield. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Throwing now is Allen. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Josh Allen, very athletic at 6'5", showing the versatility, picking up the first on the scramble.
This guy's proven himself to be one of the best in the NFL. He brings an added dimension to their offense with his ability to read defenses and know when he's able to pull it down and take off and go.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. On the give, this is Singletary. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Allen going to throw. And he will find Davis. That's complete. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 17-yard line. 11 more yards there, and this methodical drive continues.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now flags will come in. One of the Bills got going a little early. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
On the handoff, running left, Singletary. He'll be brought down short of the 15, but a really good move on the run. 79 yards rushing for him now to this point. Good gain there on first down. It keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay there.
He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Call it a loss of 5, a big sack to bring up third down. Well, we've seen how this quarterback can beat you with his legs. Saw it earlier on this drive, as a matter of fact. But that time, they had him covered.
They really gave him no place to escape, because oftentimes they're able to find a crack, a sliver, anything that can get them upfield. On that occasion, nothing open at all, and they swarmed him.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Allen now looks to throw. The throw on target to his receiver, McKenzie. And he's going to come up well short as they rally up to stop him at about the 16. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Bit of a pressure spot here for Tyler Bass. This to get the lead up to 4. The kick by Bass is good, and that'll move their lead up to 4 now. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now, because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. So after knocking through the field goal, here's Bass to kick it away. No run back here for Jones, a touchback.
Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6.
Jones now throwing on first down. Now thrown to Parker, complete on the slant. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Now Jones on first down, connecting with that. And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. Now this is picked up by the Bills. On the move past the 40, on the move past the 40. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
They'll run on first down with Singletary, and he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Singletary again. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Allen to throw. He finds his man complete. That's McKenzie. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And they will take a knee here. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. On the handoff, it's Singletary. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
Obviously, Charles, such an important, well-executed touchdown, and that caps off what has been a strong second half. Remember, they trailed at halftime.
And how about the response? That's the type of thing that every team talks about before a season begins. Don't worry about the scoreboard at the half. Let's play strong in the second and come out and take the fight to our opponent. They did exactly that, and now they have the lead to show for it.
Bass on for the extra point. And that one pushes the lead up to 11. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And it was finished off by a Devin Singletary touchdown run. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. So now Jones and the Patriots down by 11, 50 seconds to go. It's an extremely tall order in front of them, but they've got the ball with a first down. Jones. He'll get this underneath to Stevenson.
And he's taken down. It's a gain of 3 from the 17 to the 20. Short play like that in this situation this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Madden used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them, not what they need.
He's going to let it fly. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Here's Jones. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Well, somebody lit a fire under that offense during the break, Charles. Remember, they trailed at intermission. They come out, they have the big second half, and that lifts them to the victory.
And Brandon, trailing at halftime, we always talk about teams making adjustments. You know what the best adjustments usually are? It's just executing better. Because the game plan you put in place at the beginning of the week often still holds. You don't have to make wholesale changes. Just have to do it a little bit better, a little cleaner. And they did that in the second half, and that led them to victory.